How do I scan nuclear power station computers without an internet connection? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. And yes, this actually was a very real question. I'll throw the full question here on the screen. But the bottom line is that this actually applies to just about any situation where a machine is not connected to the internet. Here are the restrictions, at least, that were specified for this specific nuclear power station example. They can't install an antivirus because it conflicts with their software. They have no internet connection. They have no Windows updates because those could result in conflicts. They're not allowed to open their computers. And there's only a 1 month window every year where the system actually can be maintained, updated, or whatnot. So my initial reaction to the question is actually really simple. Don't get me wrong, I'm happy with Windows, I'm a fan, but putting the phrase nuclear power station and Microsoft Windows in the same context, it kind of makes me nervous. For reasons that I'll explain a little later, that doesn't seem like the combination that helps people sleep at night. So the good news here is that all of the things that are in place that keep the machine secure, the lack of updates, the lack of connectivity, and so on, those things make it very difficult to perform a scan or do any updates. However, they also make it very difficult for malware to arrive in the first place, as it should be. That's probably the majority of the intent behind being that restrictive. That's not to say that malware can't still arrive. We've certainly heard scenarios of machines being infected via other means not involving an internet connection. But the bottom line is that it is the primary vector these days. Connectivity is where most malware comes from. So by not having connectivity to an outside world, that's pretty good. I do want to point out, however, that updates are for more than just security. So not taking updates for upwards of a year makes me really uncomfortable. Again, security may not be quite as much of an issue since so little is presumably changing on that machine, but updates include bug fixes. Yeah, they include features, I get that, but they include bug fixes in addition to security updates. Let's face it, security updates are in fact themselves bug fixes. My concern would be that a machine in that environment could potentially run into a very rare, obscure bug for which a fix had already been produced and still fall to the bug with unexpected, unintended consequences. So it makes me really uncomfortable to not take updates for close to a year. I'd probably see if there weren't some way to reconsider that. I've got a bigger reconsideration coming up, but I would at least consider making an argument for doing something a little bit more often than once a year. So, how do you scan for malware if you don't have internet? Well, it's actually pretty simple. You, on a machine that does have internet, download something, write it to a USB stick or burn it to a CD-ROM or a DVD-ROM, and then take that to the machine that you want to scan. In years past, I say, yep, got the solution for you. It's called Windows Defender Offline. It's designed for exactly this scenario. You would burn it to a CD or a DVD or a USB stick. You'd boot from it and Windows Defender would do its thing. For reasons that I still don't understand, Windows Defender is no longer available in that scenario. Windows Defender Offline doesn't exist in a burn to CD kind of scenario. It still exists, but it now runs only from the operating system itself. In other words, you have to boot into the operating system in order to run Windows Defender offline. That means a couple of things. One, if your machine's a year out of date, Windows Defender is a year out of date, and the machine's got to be running. It just seems like a very ineffective solution, certainly for the scenario that we're discussing here. However, there are other options. The manufacturers of a number of anti-malware or security software packages actually provide something along these very lines. In many cases, you can find from those manufacturers a downloadable ISO or something that can be written to a USB stick from which you can then boot the machine in question and run up-to-date security scans. I have a list of them in the article, a list of bootable security tools, and I've not used any of them. But if there is a security vendor with which you already have a relationship, check with them first. On that list then also will be a number of really familiar names in the security space. Choose one of the ones that you feel most comfortable with and give that one a run. Now, I will say that this is something that you need to do, for lack of a better term, at the last minute. The bottom line is that you want that security package that you're downloading to be as up-to-date as possible. And that typically means downloading the most recent copy you can get. Like I say, at the last minute, then taking it to your machines, running your scans, and doing whatever it is you need to do. That's what I would do in your scenario. If you need to run an offline scan, then periodically download one of these disks, burn it to CD, DVD, or a USB stick, and then boot the machines from that stick in order to run the scan. Now, I want to go back to talking about Windows and nuclear power because, like I said, it feels icky, for lack of a more scientific term. Windows is a great operating system for personal use, for business use, and it's done some amazing things. There are like huge, huge enterprises, websites, services that are all running on Windows. Ultimately, having life-critical systems assigned to a Windows machine are the kinds of things that make me feel uncomfortable. Besides, there are alternatives. Now, I realize that as the person in charge of at least doing the security scans, this might be outside of your scope. But for the record, there are other, better, more purpose-driven operating systems out there that I think would be a better choice for these kinds of operations. They're typically called real-time operating systems or whatever, but there are better choices, I would think, than for Windows. Now, to be clear, if these are machines that are just running your bookkeeping operations or something else that happens to be on the same site as your nuclear power plant, fine. I'm not worried. But if it's actually in charge of the equipment that pulls the rods or does whatever with your nuclear power plant, that's the time where even I am going to say, no, Windows isn't really the solution for this. Hope that's helpful. Hope it's not too scary for everybody else. For updates, for comments, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/3848. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is AskLeo.com.